The next point that I want to speak about, my brothers and my sisters, and this is the second part of this introduction, is not acting upon your knowledge. Abu Abd al-Rahman al-Sulami al-Kufi, the individual, my brothers and my sisters, that taught Hassan and Hussein, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the two children of Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, one not acting upon his knowledge is a reason where an individual, he misses out on the barakah, the blessing of knowledge. And as I mentioned, my brothers and my sisters, a number of times, this knowledge that we are learning, the description of the wudu of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we're not just trying to take the theoretical side of things, but upon learning it, we want to go and implement it straight away. Hence why previously when I taught this course, one thing that I kept on stressing to the students is, as soon as we finish this course today, I want every single one of you guys to enter into the bathroom and to implement the wudu that you've just learned. Because there's many things that we are going to be learning that we may have been oblivious about, that we may not necessarily have known. And inshallah ta'ala, through that, we are going to increase our chances of accompanying the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of resurrection. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-mar'u ma'a man ahab. One is going to be with those who he loves. And by us implementing this, this is a sign that we love the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned something very, very profound. He said, ليس العلم ما حفظ العلم ما نفع. The real knowledge isn't that which has been memorized, but rather is that which has benefited you. And the reason why he said this, and he also mentioned another profound statement, is when he said, الناس يقولون العلم ما حفظ وأنا أقول العلم ما دخل معك القبر. People say that ilm is that which one memorizes, but I say to you, the real ilm is that which enters with you in the grave. Why did he mention this, my brothers and my sisters? As he just said, there was many people who were saying that the real ilm is that which has been memorized. Is that an incorrect statement? The answer is no. But if one begins to think that ilm is just all about memorizing, I'm just going to memorize all of these hadith without actually applying it in my life, then this is a distorted understanding of how to go about seeking the sacred knowledge. Even Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, ليس العلم بكثرة الرواية إنما العلم الخشية. Ilm isn't just having so many narrations that one has noted down or has memorized, but rather, my brothers and my sisters, العلم is what الخشية. You fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that knowledge that you have attained. You find yourself in an instance where the knowledge that you have learnt is now calling you to not embark on the sin that is right before your eyes. And then you refrain from it. This, my brothers and my sisters, is the essence of al-khashya, where an individual now has refrained from doing something because of the knowledge that he has attained. Also, my brothers and my sisters, Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, هَتَفَ الْعِلْمُ بِالْعَمَلِ فَإِنْ أَجَابَهُ وَإِلَّا ارْتَحَلْ. He said, the ilm, it called out. Imagine making a phone call to actions. Just imagine this for a moment. The ilm, he makes a phone call all the way to the amal, the actions. Of course, they didn't have phone calls in the time of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, but you understand what I'm saying. So he called out to him, saying, act upon me. فَإِنْ أَجَابَهُ وَإِلَّا ارْتَحَلْ. Either he acts upon this, my brothers and my sisters, otherwise that ilm is going to disappear. And this is exactly, my brothers and my sisters, the effects of not acting upon that knowledge. Another profound statement, my beloved brothers and sisters, is that which Al-Imam Shafi rahimahullah ta'ala said. He said, إن الفقيه هو الفقيه بفعله ليس الفقيه بنطقه ومقاله. The real faqih is the faqih who acts upon his knowledge. And the faqih isn't the one who just says and the one who just claims. So you just being able to quote ahadith and the masail al-fiqhiyah, the fiqhi related matters, then the reality of the matter is if an individual is not going to act upon it, then this doesn't show an individual's prominence in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala, he was asked about an individual who is excessive in collecting a hadith. He said, يَنْبَغِي أَنْ يَكْثُرَ الْعَمَلَ بِهِ عَلَىٰ قَدَرِ زِيَادَةِ فِي الْعِلْمِ. The more an individual increases in knowledge, it is only appropriate that he increases in actions. In another statement, he says, سَبِيلُ الْعِلْمِ مِثْلُ سَبِيلِ الْمَالِ. Ilm is like the wealth. How is that, my brothers and my sisters? كُلَّمَ ازْدَادَ مَالُ الْمَرْءِ ازْدَادَتْ زَكَاتُهُ. The more the wealth of an individual increases, then his zakat increases as well, right? And this is exactly how one should be with regards to his knowledge. The more he seeks knowledge, the more he should be increasing in acts of worship. A student of knowledge, my brothers and my sisters, is not like everybody else. We just mentioned now the statement of Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala. The more one increases in knowledge, it only makes sense that he increases in acting upon that knowledge as well. He does more than everyone else. Look what Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned. يَنْبَغِي لِحَامِلِ الْقُرْآنِ أَنْ يُعْرَفَ بِلَيْلِهِ إِذَا النَّاسُ نَائِمُونَ وَبِنَهَارِهِ إِذَا النَّاسُ مُفْطِرُونَ. It is only appropriate for someone who's carrying the Qur'an, لِحَامِلِ الْقُرْآنِ, that he is known for his nights when the people are sleeping, and for his days when the people are not fasting. This حامل القرآن, this person who is carrying the Qur'an, he is known to be fasting. Muhammad ibn Sirin, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, لِيَكُنْ لَكَ حَضٌ مِنْ قِيَامِ اللَّيْلِ وَلَوْ بِمِقْدَارِ حَلْبِشَاتِ. One should have the portion of the night. One should wake up for a portion of the night, even if it means that it is the duration that it takes to milk a sheep. You, O student of knowledge, you're not like the random ami who does his 9 to 5, 5 days a week. And you find that the more you act upon it, the more the people around you will benefit from that which you say. And this is a type of ta'zeem that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to that person who glorifies his religion, glorifies his book, glorifies the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, فَعَلَىٰ قَدَرِ مَحَبَّةِ الرَّجُلِ لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يُحِبُّهُ اللَّهِ وَيُحِبُّهُ الْخَلْقِ. In accordance to how much one loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you find that Allah azza wa jal will love him, and also you find that the creation will love him in accordance to that as well. وَعَلَىٰ قَدْرِ تَعْظِيمِهِ لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يُعَظِّمْهُ الْخَلْقِ. And in accordance to how much you glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find that the creation, they will hold you in high esteem. Let me now mention something very powerful that Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned with regards to some of his mashayikh, some of his teachers. Look what he said, and this really, really touched me, guys. He said, لَقِيتُ مَشَايِخَ أَحْوَالُهُمْ مُخْتَلِفَةً. He said, I met many of the mashayikh, and they had different situations. يَتَفَاوَتُونَ فِي مَقَادِيرِهِمْ فِي الْعِلْمِ. And they had different levels of knowledge. And then look what he said. وَكَانَ أَنْفَعُهُمْ لِي فِي صُحْبَةٍ الْعَامِلَ مِنْهُمْ بِعِلْمِهِ وَإِنْ كَانَ غَيْرُهُ أَعْلَمَ مِنْهُ. But he said, those who have found the most beneficial when it came to accompanying them are those who used to act upon their knowledge. وَإِنْ كَانَ غَيْرُهُ أَعْلَمَ مِنْهُ. Even though there were others who were more knowledgeable. SubhanAllah. That really, really, my brothers and my sisters, should have an impact on our hearts. Sometimes we wonder, we're trying to give advice to the people. We mention a hadith to them. We try to bring them the haqq, right? A lot of the time you find that it might just fall on deaf ears. Of course, it could be because of that individual's stubbornness and his arrogance, but it also could be because how do we expect people to listen to us when we ourselves haven't listened to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The knowledge that we had went through one ear and it came out the other. But when we find ourselves in gatherings, we want to show everybody that we know and that we've learnt, right? And then look what he said. وَلَقِيتُ جَمَاعَةً مِنْ أَهْلِ الْحَدِيثِ. I met a group of those who ascribe themselves to a hadith, the people of hadith. يَحْفَظُونَ وَيَعْرِفُونَ. They would memorize and they also had understanding. وَلَكِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يَتَسَامَحُونَ فِي غِيبَةٍ يُخْرِجُونَهَا مَخْرَجَ جَرْحٍ وَتَعْدِيلٍ. But they took it very lightly to backbite one another. And whenever they backbited, they would do this under the banner of al-jarhu wa-ta'dil, disparaging and also praising. This is a field that is studied in the sciences of hadith, subhanAllah. Something that is very common at this moment in time, right? وَيَأْخُذُونَ عَلَىٰ قِرَاءَةِ الْحَدِيثِ أَجْرًا. And when narrating the hadith, they would take a payment for it. وَيُسْرِعُونَ بِالْجَوَابِ لِأَنَّا يَنْكَسِرَ الْجَاهُ وَإِنْ وَقَعَ الْخَطَأَ. And they would rush and hasten to giving answers when being asked questions, just so that they don't drop in the eyes of the people, even though that which they were answering with was not correct. And then look what he says. وَلَقِيتُ عَبْدَ الْوَهَّابِ الْأَنْمَاطِ. I met an individual called عَبْدُ الْوَهَّابِ الْأَنْمَاطِ. فَكَانَ عَلَىٰ قَانُونِ السَّلَفِ. He was upon the way of the Salaf. لَمْ يُسْمَعْ فِي مَجْلِسِهِ غِيبَةٌ وَلَا كَانَ يَطْلُبُ أَجْرًا عَلَىٰ إِسْمَاعِ الْحَدِيثِ. It was never heard that he used to backbite in his sittings. And he never used to request a payment for narrating a hadith. وَكُنْتُ إِذَا قَرَأْتُ عَلَيْهِ أَحَادِيثَ الرَّقَائِقِ بَكَى. And whenever I read the hadith to him that was related to the hadith of heart softness, he would begin to cry, وَاتَّصَلَ بُكَاءُ. And then you would find that his tears just wouldn't stop. It would just continuously continue. And then look what he said, فَكَانَ وَأَنَا صَغِيرُ السِّنِّ حِينَ إِذٍ. And at the time, I was young in age, when I used to attend his gatherings. يَعْمَلُ بُكَاءُهُ فِي قَلْبِهِ وَيَبْنِي قَوَاعِدٍ. Him crying would really have an effect on my heart. وَكَانَ عَلَىٰ سَمْتِ الْمَشَايِقِ الَّذِينَ سَمِعْنَا أَوْصَافَهُمْ فِي النَّقْلِ. And the description that I saw with this individual, the characteristics and the attributes that he had, was that which we used to hear about the people of the Salaf, the people who have passed, those we used to read in the narrations, the biographies of those who have passed us and preceded us in al-Iman. And then he mentions another of his mashayikh, of his teachers. وَلَقِيتُ أَبَا مَنْصُورِ وَلَقِيتُ أَبَا مَنْصُورِ الْجَوَالِيقِ فَكَانَ كَثِيرُ الصَّمْتِ. He says about his other teacher, he was somebody who used to remain silent quite often. شَدِيدَ التَّحَرِّي فِيمَا يَقُولُ. He was extra careful with that which he says. He would think twice. He wasn't somebody who was just hasty in just speaking, but rather he thought twice about what came out of his mouth. مُتْقِنًا مُحَقِّقًا. He was somebody who was solid. وَرُبَّمَا سُئِلَ الْمَسْأَلَةَ الظَّاهِرَةَ. And perhaps he would be asked a very easy question. أَلَّتِي يُبَادِرُ بِجَوَابِهَا بَعْضُ غِلْمَانِهِ. A type of issue that some of his children, some of his small students, they would rush to answering. فَيَتَوَقَّفُ فِيهَا حَتَّى يَتَيَقَّنُ. He would refrain from answering that question until he is certain. وَكَانَ كَثِيرُ الصَّوْمِ وَصَمْتِ. He was somebody who used to remain silent quite often, and he used to also fast a lot as well. And then look what he says. فَانْتَفَعْتُ بِهَذَيْنِ الرَّجُلَيْنِ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ انْتِفَاعِي بِغَيْرِهِمَا. I benefited from these two individuals more than that which I benefited from others. فَفَهِمْتُ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْحَالَةِ أَنَّ الدَّلِيلَ بِالْفِعْلِ أَرْشَدُ مِنَ الدَّلِيلِ بِالْقَوْلِ. So he said, I learned from this that actions speak louder than words. أَنَّ الدَّلِيلَ الْفِعْلِ أَرْشَدُ مِنْ الدَّلِيلِ بِالْقَوْلِ. We hear a lot about this, right? Actions speak louder than words. Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned this to us hundreds and hundreds of years ago. Subhanallah. So if you want to be somebody, my brothers and my sisters, that has an effect on the people's hearts, when you stand on the minbar, when you're in a gathering, or you're trying to advise, be that individual who really glorifies the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So look what Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala mentions. A statement that is very, very close to my heart. He said, فَعَلَى قَدْرِ مَحَبَّةِ الْعَبْدِ لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يُحِبُّهُ الْخَلْقِ. In accordance to how much you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creation will love you. وَعَلَى قَدْرِ خَوْفِهِ مِنَ اللَّهِ يَخَافُهُ الْخَلْقِ. And in accordance to how much you have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you find that the creation will be in awe of you as well. And then he concludes, وَعَلَى قَدْرِ تَعْظِيمِهِ لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يُعَظِّمُهُ الْخَلْقِ. And in accordance to how much you glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, people will hold you in high esteem. Another profound statement of Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala in his kitab Miftahu Dar al-Sa'adah, where he lists so many benefits of knowledge. The sixth benefit that he mentioned is عَدَمُ الْعَمَلِ بِهِ. When he began to speak about not acting upon your knowledge, he said, فَإِنَّ الْعَمَلَ بِهِ يُوجِبُ تَذَكُّرُهُ وَتَدَبُّرُهُ. When acting upon knowledge, my brothers and my sisters, from its benefits is, it allows an individual to remember that which he has studied. And it also causes one to contemplate. And the more you think and contemplate and ponder upon something, my brothers and my sisters, the more that will stick in your mind. وَمُرَاعَاتِي وَالنَّظَرَ فِيهِ. And then look what he says. فَإِذَا أَهْمَلَ الْعَمَلَ بِهِ نَسِيَ. If it now becomes heedless and he stops acting upon that knowledge, he will forget it. And this is, my brothers and my sisters, very well known. It's something that any seeker of knowledge is aware of. And this is also something that will happen with regards to the Quran. We were told about the Quran, هُوَ أَشَدُّ تَفَلُّتًا مِنْ رَاحِلَةِ عُنُقِ أَحَدِكُمْ. It will slip away from you the same way the sheep that you have tied, or the camel that you have tied somewhere, that will slip away if you don't tie it properly. And then look what he says. قَالَ بَعْضُ السَّلَفِ. Some of the Salaf mentioned, كُنَّا نَسْتَعِينُ عَلَى حِفْظِ الْعِلْمِ بِالْعَمَلِ. We used to seek assistance in acting upon the knowledge in that which we used to memorize. So by acting upon that knowledge, it would help them with their memorization. So you go into the toilet, my brothers and my sisters, into the bathroom, and you're making wudu the same way you've just been taught. It will allow you to just remember that knowledge for months to come. And the more you act upon it, it will stay with you for years. So much so that it becomes carved within you. Also Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions, وَالْمِسْكِينُ كُلُّ الْمِسْكِينُ. The real poor individual is مَنْ ضَاعَ عُمُرُهُ فِي عِلْمٍ لَمْ يَعْمَلْ بِهِ. It's the one who wasted his life in not acting upon the knowledge that he pursued. فَفَاتَتْهُ لَذَّاتُ الدُّنْيَا. And the sweetness of this dunya has surpassed him, has slipped away from him. وَخَيْرَاتُ الْآخِرَةُ. and also the goodness of the hereafter. فَقَدِّمَ مُفْلِسًا مَا قُوَّةِ الْحُجَّةِ عَلَيْهِ. And he will come on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ as somebody who is bankrupt, while at the same time the evidences are going to be pointing against him. It is going to be what? A plea against him, because he learned, he knew, and he didn't act upon it. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, and I'm going to conclude this point with it inshaAllah ta'ala, الرِّفْعَةُ لَا تَكُونُ بِمُجَرَّدِ الْعِلْمِ بَلْ بِاتِّبَاعِ الْحَقِّ وَالْعَمَلِ بِهِ. One being raised isn't just going to be due to having mere knowledge. Just having knowledge, it's not going to be the reason why a person is raised in this dunya and likewise the akhirah. But rather, he says, بَلْ بِاتِّبَاعِ الْحَقِّ وَالْعَمَلِ بِهِ. But rather, by following the truth and acting upon it.